You know, this is the first time I've looked at this house from the ground, and it looks so much better when I'm standing on the ground than flying up. What's up, guys? It's Niall, and today I'm going to be giving y'all a guide on how to build movie theaters in your houses. And this room right here is going to be the one we're doing it in, because I wasn't exactly sure what to put in this room for the longest time, and I finally came to the conclusion that this is a perfect room for a movie theater. There is a window, but we'll put some curtains on that, and we'll get it looking really good in here. Quick update for the Niall House series fans. This room right here and this bathroom are going to be furnished off camera, because I want to make the garage video its own video, and then I'm probably going to do this porch down here off camera, just to wrap it up so we can do that cinematic, because this house is really taking me a long time, and I'm trying to like wrap it up so we can move on and get some more interesting content, you know, coming out. Okay, so let's get started. So the way I'm going to go about doing this is I'm going to start digging out the floor, because when you're making a movie theater, you want it to be on an incline so that seats are above the people in front of them, so nobody's blocking each other's view. So after I dug down the different levels, I filled in the wall area around here to just kind of, you know, not have stone. So basically what's going on here is I saved a little slot so I could put stairs like this. And then also I made them 3 blocks wide so I could put a chair or whatever, but you could still walk in front of it and it wouldn't take up the whole area. And 3 is enough because this is a home movie theater and it doesn't have to be like way too big or anything. Okay, so I just realized something that I wasn't going to point out before, but it definitely is important here because now I've got to do something to fix it. I didn't make this section from this block to this block odd numbers, so it's an even number, so there's 2 blocks that make the center. And I want to make a projector that looks like decent and not 2 blocks wide, so now I've got to shorten this by 1 block to make that possible. So what I'm going to do to shorten is I'm just going to curve all the stairs on the end, and then I can center my screen between this block and this block on this wall and put on my stairs and stuff, and then I can center that projector on the wall like so. I'm also just now realizing how dark it is in here, so I'm gonna light it up temporarily until we can figure out what we want to do for lighting. Now for the chairs, this is pretty much just personal preference. However, I would recommend using a chair design like this, to where you put 2 stairs like that and then put 2 full blocks behind those stairs and then finish it off with 2 stairs in the opposite direction. And it makes a really full chair that you can actually like get into. And I mean, that looks exactly like a real chair. They are a little large, but as long as you're planning it out beforehand, it shouldn't be hard to fit into your build. Okay, so remember that little thing I did here with the stair to get the number correct? Well, it actually backfired on me because I ended up skipping 1 block right here. So now it's once again 2 in the middle. So what I'm going to do to fix this is I'm going to revert the change that I made earlier. I'm going to move over this chair by 1 block, and then I'm going to make the middle chairs a little bit bigger, almost like a love seat or something, just to kind of change up the seating arrangements that you could do in your movie theater. Because there's all kinds of movie theaters. I've seen videos of like mansions out, you know, in California that just have massive like beds as the seats instead. So let's see how it turns out. Okay, so problem solved, and now we have a center block right here. If you are making this from scratch, I would recommend, if you're gonna use these chairs, to do one here, one here. Have this little block like between the 2 chairs be the middle point in 4 chairs in a row, if that makes sense. Kind of sounded complicated now that I'm thinking about it, but hopefully that made sense. Okay, now that that's done, we can start working on the screen. So to remind myself where the screen is supposed to be, I lined up these 2 pillars with the outside of each chair so that I know it needs to be centered within these 2 points, because this area over here is staircase and this doesn't need to be centered with the screen. For the actual screen, I'd recommend always using black concrete, because once you put it together, you can't really replicate a TV better than this in like Minecraft, you know. Now movie theaters are a little different. Like if you're doing it in like, if you're actually making a large movie theater, you might even want to use white for the screen, but black or white works. It just depends on how realistic you want the build to actually like look, because it is a projector, so they are projecting the screen onto most likely a white background. So this is the screen size I settled for this movie theater, because it's not too big for how like big the whole room in general is. But I also have room for speakers and stuff on both sides of the screen. For the speakers, I'm going to use a lodestone block, and I'm going to put 3 on this side and 3 on this side. And it really gives off an actual like speaker kind of look. You can also do these with banners if you would like a more realistic looking one though. And then also I'm going to put one back here and one back here to give the effect that there's like surround sound in the room. So this house, the coastal style mansion, has a brown theme to the whole build. So I'm going to incorporate that into this room since it's kind of not really matching the color scheme very well. And I'm just going to do that by just throwing some accents in here that will kind of make it blend in with the rest of the house. And then I'm also going to work on some designs over here in a little bit. For another wood accent, I'm going to do a shelf design, and then I'm going to come in and I'm actually going to put some leaves in the shelf design because that is a big feature of this house. It has a lot of green involved in like certain rooms. All right, so now we've got a shelf and there's a little bit of green splashed around here. I even put some on the back row just to kind of tie the whole room in because we don't want all the green on the front side of the room. We want some on the back too. And now we're ready for the projector, and then we'll move on to that design I was talking about. For the location of the projector, if it's a home movie theater, I'd recommend finding this, the area where you walk to the seats in the back row. Go to that middle block and go straight above it. For the projector design is I'm going to put a grindstone down like this, and then below it I'm gonna actually put a hopper. Let's do like this, and then we'll do the hopper facing into that block, so when I destroy it, it looks like a little projector aiming out that way. And also I'm gonna come in here and I'm gonna put an upside down stair under both these speakers just to look like they're mounted to the wall. And I just realized these bushes right here are a good place to hide some ambient lighting, so you don't have to throw as many lights around the room and make them super obvious. And I'm gonna do the same thing below this bush over here in the corner. So now for the wall design, I'm gonna find the area where each seat starts, which is this block where you actually sit in it. And I'm gonna go to the wall over here and I'm just gonna cut out a section. I'm gonna do this on every floor and I'm gonna go down one block for each one. So now it should be kind of like a cascading design. From here, I'm just gonna put an inward wooden stair to tie in with the theme on every single one. And then in these designs, you can pretty much put whatever you want back there. I'm just gonna put these logs. You could put another source of lighting if you wanted, but I'm actually gonna do that on the outside, which I'll show you in a second. Okay, so now that I have that, I'm just gonna grab a half slab of dark oak, and I'm just gonna grab that half slab and put it right there. And I'm going to put a lantern hanging from that. So now, if I destroy those two, the room is pretty well lit. Like, it's a movie theater, so I kept it kind of dim, but this is the lighting I was kind of going for. You know, and now that I think about it, I'm going to go ahead and put two more of these just to make it symmetrical because it was kind of bothering me. And now we're pretty much done. I'm just going to add one more feature, and that's just going to be a backboard. So I'm going to grab a spruce half slab, and I'm just going to come back here, and I'm just going to line it right one block above all of these and then close them. And that just completes the theme. I actually almost forgot. I didn't add any detail to these windows, so I'm gonna put an upside down stair here. And now I'm going to grab some banners and I'm gonna come in and put some curtains. The white banners fit in with this theme pretty well. So basically what I'd recommend is to just place them down until they pretty much cover the whole window. You can maybe leave a sliver of the window open just to create some depth to the room. And just like that, we've completed the movie theater. So I hope this guide kind of helped and gave you some inspiration for how you should begin to tackle your movie theater room. Because you can really do a movie theater in so many different ways, but sometimes it just helps to get a little bit of inspiration, and then you can go from there and make your own design. So let me know if it helps in the comments section below. If you enjoyed the video, like it, and maybe even subscribe, and I'll see y'all next time. Peace out.